We were made to be courageous. We were made to lead the way. We could be the generation that finally breaks the chains. We were made to be courageous. We were made to be courageous. We were warriors on the front lines, standing unafraid. But now we're watchers on the sidelines while our families slip away. Where are you, men of courage? You were made for so much more. Let the pounding of our hearts cry, we will serve the Lord. We were made to be courageous and we're taking back the fight. We were made to be courageous and it starts with us tonight. The only way we'll ever stand is on our knees with lifted hands. Make us courageous. Lord, make us courageous. This is our resolution, our answer to the call. We will love our wives and children. We refuse to let them fall. We will reignite the passion that we bury deep inside. May the watchers become warriors. Let the men of God arise. We were made to be courageous and we're taking back the fight. We were made to be courageous and it starts with us tonight. The only way we'll ever stand is on our knees with lifted hands. Make us courageous. Lord, make us courageous.
I lose. the world, light into my life. I will live for you alone. You're the one I seek, knowing I will find all I need in you alone, in you alone. Where you go,
isn't that-
not what it was meant to be. All this pain, all this suffering, there's a better place waiting for me in heaven. Every tear will be wiped away, every sorrow and sin erased. We'll dance on seas of amazing grace in heaven. In heaven, I'm going home where the streets are golden. Every chain.
And like a flood, his
my hope secure. He were my shield and ocean me as long as life endures. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy reigns unending.
Oh, never found. Trying to find 6 feet on the ground. Under the weight of all of my sin. Fighting the fight that I couldn't win. And you rescued me. And now I can breathe. I was a dead man walking.
Hey, Zach, thanks for sending that message. This is my friend, Caleb.
Good to meet you.
And I think it's really cool that you have had Randall in your life to get you involved in Jesus Christ and help you to build your faith. I think it's really special that God gives us those relationships in our lives to help us, to better us, and also to better his other children.
Yeah, I think it's really important to know, like, that God has not just given us these relationships to end at death. You know, because of his son, Jesus Christ, everyone will live again, and Jesus Christ has suffered all of our pains and even our sorrows. He knows exactly what this feels like, and because of that, he can get you through this. And because of him and his great sacrifice, there is life after death, and there's more to the picture.
Because we know that after our time is here complete on earth, after we've done those things that Christ has wanted us to do, then it goes on. There's more after this. Because there's very important work that goes on after we call it the spirit world. And it's there, before we're resurrected, that a lot of missionary work goes on. Because there are a lot of people in life that have never had the opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as their Savior and to do the necessary things to follow him, like baptism, by the proper authority. And so that's where his faithful servants go, as they help to bring others to the faith.
Yeah, and it's so important to me to know that God isn't going to leave anyone behind. You know, he doesn't just keep those who did their best and were always perfect, because none of us are. But even those who never really had that chance to learn about Jesus Christ, or maybe didn't even really live that great of lives, will have that chance to learn about Jesus Christ. And those who have been able to accept him and accept his gospel will have that chance to share with them. And that way, everyone can feel that peace and hope that comes through Jesus Christ. because it really does add so much to our lives.
Yeah, and this is a part of what we call the plan of salvation or the plan of happiness. And this is the plan that Jesus Christ and God set forth so that we as people could have purpose and the things that we're supposed to do. And we'd love to share more with it about you because it's brought me a lot of peace in my life as I've gone through similar struggles. I haven't gone through anything exactly like you have, but I know that this has brought me a lot of peace and we'd love to share that with you sometime.
Yeah, we wonder if we could do like a video call sometime and just share really this whole plan and how Jesus Christ is the center of it and how much hope there is to it. But let us know if we could do that.
Have a good one.